वॉच दिस रेसिपी इन हिंदी, चेक द लिंक इन डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स बिलो एंड ऑल्सो सब्सक्राइब मृदुलास कुक बुक हिंदी चैनल. हेलो एवरी वन, आई एम मृदुला एंड वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल. टुडे इज गणेश चतुर्थी एंड आई विश ऑल माई व्यूअर्स अ वेरी हैप्पी गणेश चतुर्थी. दिस फेस्टिवल इज इन कम्प्लीट विदाउट ऑफरिंग लॉर्ड गणेशा विथ मोदक्स. देर आर मेनी वराइटी ऑफ मोदक रेसिपीज, बट टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर अ ट्रेडिशनल वे ऑफ मेकिंग स्टीम मोदक्स. आई एम ऑल्सो गोइंग टू शेयर अ लॉट ऑफ टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स, सो डू वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल दी एंड. There are two parts for this recipe. First is the filling and other is the outer cover. So for the filling, we need 2 cups of fresh grated coconut. For 2 cups of coconut, we need 1 cup of jaggery, which is also known as gur. I have taken some finely chopped cashews and almonds. You can also use raisins if you like. 1 teaspoon of crushed green cardamom. 1 tablespoon ghee, that is clarified butter. And 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg powder. To make its outer cover, we need rice flour. This is homemade rice flour. And it is very important that you use homemade rice flour to get best result. Now let's talk about the variety of rice that can be used. You can use any variety of rice, but the rice should not be too old nor too new. It should be medium aged rice. It is preferred to use rice which is aromatic, that will give good flavor to the modak. Now there are some varieties of aromatic rice which I know, like basmati rice, ambe mohar, govind bhog and sambar rice. Try to use any of these varieties, or you can just go with any variety of medium aged raw rice which is available. To make rice flour, I am using basmati rice. Wash this rice couple of times. Spread it on a dry cotton cloth. Allow this rice to dry under running fan for 6 to 8 hours. Take this rice to flour mill to grind it fine. It is not possible to grind this fine in mixer grinder at home. If you don't have time to do all this process of making rice flour, then you can use ready-made store-bought rice flour. Okay, so let's see other ingredients. For 1 cup of rice flour, we need 1 cup of water, 1 tablespoon of ghee, pinch of salt to taste, 1/2 teaspoon sugar and 2 tablespoon milk. First, let's make the filling. It's very easy and it doesn't take much time to cook. In a pan, heat a tablespoon ghee, then add in fresh grated coconut. Set the flame on medium and saute this till the coconut becomes little dry. You can see the coconut has dried a little. Now add in jaggery. Continue to cook this till the jaggery melts completely. You can see the jaggery has melted and it has mixed well with the coconut. Finally, add in rest of the ingredients, chopped cashew, almonds, cardamom powder. Also add in nutmeg powder. Our filling is ready. Take this out in a bowl. Now let's make the outer cover. For that, in a pan add water, salt, sugar, 1 tablespoon ghee and milk. Set the flame on high and wait till this comes to a boil. Once you see this has come to a boil, now lower the flame and add in rice flour. Quickly mix everything up. Once all the flour has soaked up the water, switch off the flame, put the lid on and keep this aside for at least 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, take the mixture out in a large plate. While this mixture is still hot, start kneading. At first, this mixture might feel a little dry and crumbly. So sprinkle a little water and try to get this mixture together to form a dough. It is important that you knead this dough very well for at least 8 to 10 minutes. If this dough is not kneaded well, then it will crack while making modak. The dough should be just like the regular roti dough that we make, not too soft or not too hard. This is done. Divide the dough and make small lemon sized balls. Cover these balls with a wet cloth or else they will become dry. So all the preparation is done. Our filling and the dough is ready. We also need some rice flour. So now let's see how to shape it. Take a ball of dough and coat with some dry flour. You can either use dry flour or you can also apply some ghee on your finger and make modak. Using thumb finger on left hand, keep pressing in the middle of the dough, and using fingers on the other hand, gently keep pressing around the edges. Now rice flour doesn't have gluten in it, so when you spread the dough, it will start to crack from the edges. Hence, we need to constantly keep pressing at the edges to prevent it from cracking. Shape this dough to make a small bowl. Try to make it little thin. If there are any cracks at the edges, just join them by pinching them slightly. Take a spoonful of filling and place it at the center. Now we need to make the pleats. We need to use thumb, pointer and middle finger. Place pointer finger inside the bowl and using thumb and middle finger we need to pinch the dough from outside the bowl. Leave one finger gap and make a pleat next to the first pleat. In this way make all the pleats. After all the pleats are done, very gently bring all the pleats together in this way. Keep checking in between. Adjust the pleats to keep them straight. In this way, join all the pleats together. This is one way to make modak. If in case you are not able to make the pleats properly, then there is another simple method. Spread the dough to make a bowl. Place the filling at the center. Now don't make any pleats, just bring all the edges together. Shape it like a modak. Using a butter knife or blunt side of the knife, in this way make vertical streaks. After preparing all the modaks, we need to steam them. Place them on perforated steaming plate. Steam these modaks on medium high heat for 10 minutes. Our modak are ready. I hope you all liked today's video. If you do, then give it a like, share it with your friends and family, and also don't forget to subscribe my channel. I will be back soon with a new recipe video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.